Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in again. I'm going to start a brand new series here on Automate Your Life, and its intention is to solve real world problems with smart home or home automation technology. Now, what we're going to do today is I'm going to start a three-part series called the $325 Home Security System, and this is going to give you the opportunity to create your own home security system using smart home technology. And of course, you're not going to have to pay any of those home monitoring fees that you see on TV and in the commercials. So today's video is what I'm going to tell you you're going to want to buy for this $325 home security system. This is just the components. Part two, I'll show you how to actually get those all installed in your home. And then part three is a optional piece that I'm going to show you to save a little money. It's a little harder to set up, but ultimately I think it's worth it because it will save you a lot of money. So let's get going. All right, so now for me, when we talk about a home security system, I'm thinking about three different components. The first being, obviously, we don't want anyone who's not supposed to be in our home to be in our home. So kind of the actual security side, you want to know if someone's here and you want to be able to phone the police. Now, second to that is leak or flood detection. Water damage does a lot of damage to a lot of homes now, and I think if you've been paying attention to your insurance policies, they're not always fully covering you in all of those situations. The other thing is, of course, fire detection, fire or smoke detection, and that's actually probably the hardest piece in the smart home sector to find kind of a cost reasonable solution, actually. So those are the three things that I'm going to be solving for you here today. Now, the first component is the hub, and the hub is really important because most of the sensors that you're going to use in this are a Zigbee protocol, and Zigbee is kind of the protocol that has won out here at this point in terms of sensor technology. We've seen Z-Wave as well. That's a great protocol as well. This hub, and I have one in my home, it does incredible things when it comes to home automation. One of the other things that it does so well is it actually monitors both leaks and the security system in your home. It becomes an in-home security system, and that's base features here from the Samsung SmartThings system. So that's a $90 US hub. For you, this is probably the simplest thing to install in your home. So that device is a Samsung SmartThings water sensor detector, or water leak sensor. Now, the water leak sensor is a $25 piece from Samsung. If you were to need multiple, usually from Samsung, what you can do, you can either wait for a sale, or you can go ahead and you can buy in multiples of three or five. They sell them for cheaper at that point. But for most people, if you're in your furnace room or your room with your hot water tank, that's where you're going to need this sensor. What I've seen over the last 6 months in my home, I've had one of these and it has been nothing short of perfect. I have had one minor leak while that was here and it did alert me to that. The other thing is I've tested it multiple times and I haven't had to change a battery in it. And you would think with so much monitoring going on that you would have to do that. So the next thing I'm buying in this system is to cover what's normally the two main doors in everybody's household. So you're usually going to have a front door and a back door, and those are obviously easy entry points for people to come in. And so what I'm going to buy is the Samsung SmartThings multi-purpose sensor, and I'm going to buy two of these, and you can see, hopefully you can see the two sensor or the two pieces of this sensor. They essentially work together in terms of an electromagnetic signal. Basically, if they're close together, then Samsung knows that the door is closed, And if they're split apart, then Samsung knows that the door is open. Now, funny little piece here, these actually work on your garage door if you'd like, and lots of people have been using them for those as well. Now, in general, people have a few more places that are considered entry points for people into their homes. And I kind of think about, you know, lower level screened windows where somebody could break the screen out and then maybe take the window itself out. So what I'm going to recommend there is two more of a Samsung SmartThings device. It's a motion sensor, and these are $25 US a piece, and they work anywhere from about the 0 to the 15 foot range in terms of distance. So you actually point these motion sensors towards the entry points in your home, a couple of the windows kind of off to the side. You don't want them looking out the actual window because they'll pick up motion and changes in light outside, but they are very good inside the home at picking up motion when people are that 0 to 15 feet range away. So this overall, when you look at it, gives you 4 points within your home that you're able to monitor that, you know, are easy entry points for people into your home. So now with all of those devices purchased from Samsung, you're gonna go out and you're just gonna buy those just from Samsung. And as I said earlier, with most of those detectors, if you needed another one, you would be buying a 3-pack and the price per device goes down with Samsung. So that's a deal I've seen almost always there with Samsung. Now, after we've purchased all of those things, what we have left is $120, and that leaves us enough to purchase a Nest Smoke and CO Protect smart home monitoring sensor. So this is going to protect you from fire and, of course, carbon monoxide, which is a big killer now in the United States and Canada and around the world. So it's a really important component to your smart home, and it gives you the opportunity to sense those things when you're either at home or away, and you're going to get notifications both on your phone or a tablet, and also, of course, the audible alarm in your home, which is very important if you're in the home and we're talking about smoke or carbon monoxide. Now, I'm going to give you one little option here that allows you to remove some of the cost and complexity from the system. It's not a perfect solution, but for a lot of people, this will save them a lot of money, and so people are gonna take that, right? Now, what this is the WiseCam 2, and this is the device here. This is all you get when you buy one of these. It's a $20 US camera that you can purchase, and it's a smart home camera. It has the capability of doing 3 very important things. It's capable of motion detection and sound detection when you're away from your home. Now, on top of that, it can also listen for different types of alarms. So it can listen, and specifically in the settings for this little camera is a carbon monoxide sound or alarm detection function and a smoke alarm detection function. So it uses those standard sounds that you're going to get from your regular at-home monitors, and it will send you those notifications. Now, what I'll tell you is that this device then can replace a number of the components that we've been talking about today. So it could replace potentially the Samsung SmartThings motion sensors, which is $50 worth of equipment here, and it could potentially replace the Nest Protect CO and smoke alarm that we just talked about. Now, that would give you a savings of $170 for a $20 camera. I'd say you're probably going to need a couple of those just to make sure that you're covered throughout your home, but ultimately this could replace it. What I'm going to tell you about this little device is it is imperfect, and you will have to do a little bit of extra setup and a little bit of extra work. So come part 3 in this series, you're going to have to decide whether or not you want to head down that path. All right, there you go, guys. Those are all the different components. You can go ahead and look them all up. There's links all down below to all of the devices that I recommended today. You can go ahead, research all those items, and stay tuned for the next couple of parts in the series. So, part two, I'm going to show you how to set up the most complicated components of the system. So that's going to be the Samsung SmartThings. That's a large security system. And I'm going to show you how to, right from the box, set those up, get them working in your home, and get you set up with both a home security system and a leak system. So that's part two of this series. The third part is going to be what I just talked to you about in terms of the Wyze Cam. So I'm going to show you that option and how it can go ahead and replace all those different components to that security system and become a very key and critical piece just for that $20. So there you go, guys. We'll see you next time in part two. Thanks for watching.